A week after couple adopts triplets, doctors reveal this. When the doctor came back into the waiting room and matter-of-factly delivered the diagnosis, a wave of emotion hit her, threatening to take her under. Her skin grew cold and her heart raced as he explained what had happened. After all the hits she had taken in the last few months, she could barely cope with this news. Sarah and Andy Justice had been happily married for 3 years, and they knew they wanted to spend their lives together. They had it all, they loved each other and had a nice house in the suburbs. There was only one thing left to do to make their lives complete. They desperately wanted a baby. Then, life decided to throw the couple an unexpected curveball. Although the couple had been trying for 3 years to get pregnant, they still had trouble conceiving. Sarah had to go through disappointment and pain each time her test came back negative, and Andy blamed himself for not being able to give his wife what she so desperately wanted. Even the happiest couple's marriage would take strain in this situation, and the Justice's marriage was no different. Even though the situation was nobody's fault, Andy and Sarah's marriage began to deteriorate. The fact that they couldn't seem to have a baby hung over the couple and seeped into every corner of their lives like a slow poison. The other couples they knew were already on their second or third child, so they were reminded of their feelings of inadequacy everywhere they went. So, they decided to try something different. They decided to see a fertility specialist. Andy and Sarah lived in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Because it was a relatively small town, they struggled to find a fertility specialist in the area. They decided to widen their search and look outside their hometown and found a highly recommended doctor in St. Louis, Mo, a 6-hour drive away. Nevertheless, the Justices were determined to get help, so they made the long journey all the way to Missouri. But when they finally arrived, all the doctor had for them was bad news. The doctor told the Justices that there was no way Sarah could ever get pregnant naturally, but they had other options. He told the couple that they were good candidates for IVF, but this route wasn't ideal because there was only a 10% chance that it would work. Besides the poor success rate, this option presented another seemingly insurmountable problem. One round of IVF could set the couple back by $12,000 to $15,000. If Andy and Sarah wanted to have the best chance of the IVF taking, it would cost between $30,000 and $60,000 in total. Sarah's heart dropped. They just didn't have that kind of money, but they were still determined to grow their family. So, the Justices began to consider Plan C. Andy and Sarah were determined to explore all their options, so they decided to look into the adoption process, only to find out that this wasn't an easy option either. Before Andy and Sarah would be able to bring a baby into their home, they would have to apply through an adoption agency. If their application was approved, they would then have to pass a home study. For some reason, the Justices encountered obstacles at each step. Although Andy and Sarah knew that the adoption process could take years to complete, they applied. After a considerable amount of time, they successfully completed the application and passed the home study. Now, all they had to do was go through the interview process, or so they thought. But the couple's struggles were far from over. The Justices endured a series of grueling interviews from prospective mothers. The outcome of these interviews would ultimately decide whether they would become parents or not. After interviewing with dozens of pregnant mothers, one woman decided that the Justices were a perfect fit. Sarah and Andy took great care to support her throughout her pregnancy, but then things took a turn for the worst. Just as Andy and Sarah thought that their dreams of having a baby were coming true, the birth mother who had chosen them changed her mind. At the last minute, she decided to keep her baby. The Justices were heartbroken, but they decided to try again. Would Sarah and Andy ever fulfill their dream of being parents? The Justices pressed on and began the interview process again. Almost immediately, another prospective mother came forward and chose the couple to be her baby's adoptive parents. But then, she also changed her mind and decided to keep her baby at the last minute. Sarah and Andy were devastated, but decided to try one more time. And it was lucky that they did. Just when Sarah and Andy were about to give up, they received a call. Another pregnant woman had chosen the Justices to adopt her baby, and this time, things would be different. The birth mom included the couple in everything, and even invited them to accompany her during her first ultrasound. But nobody could have prepared for what the doctor would find. The doctor squeezed jelly on the woman's belly and probed until the picture came up on the monitor. Andy and Sarah were left reeling when the doctor spotted something strange on the scan. He went quiet and began to take measurements on the screen. Andy and Sarah's hearts dropped. After all they'd been through, they expected the worst. Thankfully, the justice's fears were unfounded. Nevertheless, nobody expected there to be three separate heartbeats in the birth mother's womb. Sarah and Andy were going to have triplets. Finally, they were going to be parents to not one, but three babies.